This is Ryan, co-founder at Interview Kickstart. The question that every engineer asks themselves at least a couple of times in their career is, how do I get into Google? We at Interview Kickstart have worked with over 2,000 candidates over the last 6 years, and here is our inside scoop. Here are our 8 suggestions for what you need to focus on to make sure that you're well prepared to nail that Google interview. Point number 1. Ask your recruiter, what level is it? L3, L4, L5, L6, L7? Are you an engineering manager? E5, E6, E7? What level are you going to be interviewed for? The reason you should do that is that based on the level, you have a different mix of coding and design questions. The general rule of thumb is, as you move more up the ladder, the more design questions you are going to get. Number 2, Google asks you very tough questions. Expect to see what you've not seen before. Google knows what questions are typically being asked, and they make sure that those are not asked in your interview process. Now, that doesn't mean, guys, that you should not go and practice what's out there, because practicing what's out there is going to give you a good sense of what to expect when you go in for that Google interview. Number 3, we all know Google asks incredibly difficult questions. But if there's one area that you should pay particular focus to, that is the area of dynamic programming. So when you are preparing for a Google interview, make sure that you take particular effort and time in the area of dynamic programming. The 4th thing you need to keep in mind is that Google questions typically will involve some amount of trade-offs. They are never black or white answers. You will be forced to make trade-offs, and there'll be varying shades of gray. If you are not seeing that, or if in your interview you feel, oh wow, this question is incredibly simple, stop, because you've probably missed something. So when you are practicing, practice questions that require you to make those trade-offs. The 5th thing you need to know when you are doing a Google interview is, don't be surprised if your interviewer actually takes a photograph of your code on the whiteboard to share it with a hiring committee member. What does that mean? Make sure that your code is neat. Make sure it's well organized. Take some time to think before you actually go ahead and start coding. Coding quality matters. The 6th thing you need to know when preparing for Google is that if you are an expert in a particular area, rest assured that one of your interviews will be with an absolute guru in your area. So make sure that you prepare on your domain incredibly well as well. The 7th thing you need to know is that, like in every top company, Google interviews will also focus on your behavioral skills. They call it goodliness. The thing to note though is that Google does not have separate behavioral rounds. They will be seeded through all the rounds that you have. So make sure that you keep that in mind while preparing. The last point you guys need to know, point number 8, is that while it might be Google, not all roles are created equally. There are some very valuable, very coveted roles. They pay incredibly well. There are other roles, not so coveted. We could call them discounted roles. It's important to know which roles you are applying for, because the coveted roles are very algorithms heavy. The non-coveted roles, not so much. They are largely domain heavy. With that, folks, I wish you all the best for upcoming Google interviews. Go ahead, give yourself the best shot, prepare well, and nail that Google interview. Thanks for watching. Once again, Ryan from Interview Kickstart, wishing you guys all the best.